back to my YouTube channel. What am I saying? I already said that. The Wasi, which is the West African. Oh my god! Which is the West African something something Council of Examination. I cannot believe I've forgotten what Wasi stands for. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Tara. If you're new here, to my returning subscribers, I just want to say thank you so much for joining me once again. I can see I have some new subscribers. Thank you so much, and I hope you like this video as well as my other videos. If you're new here, please do not forget to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. In this video, we're going to be talking about how to get into medical school. Before I do that, I just want to say that I'm a fourth year medical student at the University for Development Studies, for those of you who did not know that. So, this video has been much requested by so many of you, so we are finally doing this. And it's going to be in three stages, okay? So, I'm going to be talking about my experience getting into medical school in Ghana, as a Ghanaian in Ghana, and how to get into medical school in any, from any West African country, and how to get into medical school outside any West African country, internationally, from wherever. So let's just get right into it. First and foremost, the first thing I'd like to say is you need to absolutely be certain you want to get into medical school. I say this because 6 years is a very, 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 very long time to devote your life into doing something you do not want to do. So you need to absolutely be certain you want to get into medical school. You need to absolutely be certain you want to become a doctor. You need to find your motivation and your why. I say this because medical school is going to break you, it's going to make you, it's going to stress you out, it might even depress you sometimes. And I'm not even exaggerating at the least. So you need to absolutely be certain and know your motivation. If it's for the money, that's fine, even though it's not that much. If it's because you want to help people, you want to save lives, that's okay as well. Whatever reason it is, you need to find your motivation and find your why. Another thing I would suggest is that you need to find someone you know who is in the medical profession or who is already in medical school. Ask some questions. Just try to find out as much as you can, because honestly, you hear things about medical school and when you are outside, you think it's a lie. People tell you how stressful medical school is and you think they are just exaggerating, but it's not. So you need to find someone and ask all the right questions and prepare yourself physically, psychologically, emotionally to begin this journey for 6 months. So in Ghana, the most important factor in getting into medical school are good grades. And as a result, you need to start very early, right from junior high school. I say right from junior high school because in senior high school, you get to select a course you want to read. So if you want to be in medical school, if you want to be a doctor, it's very important you study science in senior high school. You cannot study any other course in senior high school and end up in medical school straightforward in Ghana. Because you need your 4 electives as a science student. That's elective maths, physics, chemistry, and biology. These are very important in applying for medical school in Ghana, in applying to medical school in Ghana. So you need to start early. I say you need to start early because your WASI results are very important, like the most important thing. But it helps, your assessment helps sometimes, because I think it carries about 15 to 30% of your total score in your WASI. So that's very important. So right from day one, you need to be focused, you need to try to give it as much as you can and just have good grades. You need to get straight A's. That's what everyone says, you need to get straight A's. Sometimes it's not possible to get straight A's. I personally did not get straight A's in my WASI examination, but I tried my best throughout my first year, second year, third year of senior high school. I did get straight A's, but unfortunately in my WASI, I did not get straight A's. And that was just fine because I had a couple of A's. This brings me to explaining something to you guys. The cutoff point to universities for medicine varies. Okay, some universities, the cutoff point is 606 or 08. It varies. So which means you need to get 6 A's or 4 A's and 2 B's. It varies. Okay, so what helps, what most of us do, which pushes up our chances of getting into medical school, is that when we are in our second year, we take the NOVDEC examination. So we take the NOVDEC examination, and the following year we take the WASI, which is the West African, oh my god, which is the West African something something Council of Examination. I cannot believe I've forgotten what WASI stands for. This is so embarrassing. Anyway, so you take the WASI and the NOVDEC, so you combine both results in applying to a university. This gives you a better chance of getting into medical school. Honestly, this is where you need to be praying a lot, because WASI is just something else. Applying into medical school is just something else. And I've been doing a lot of research, and I actually found out that applying to medical schools in Ghana is actually quite easier as compared to other countries, because you don't need any volunteering, you don't need to write any long essays, you don't need leadership roles or anything, you just need your grades. So life is not a competition, but getting into medical school is a competition. Third point now is applying into the university. You've made up your mind you want to be in medical school, you are working on your grades. Now it's time to apply into medical school. Usually the forms come out in the beginning of the year, and the deadline for admission, the deadline for submission of those forms, it's around June, May. I'm not really sure. I think it varies per year. So the first thing in applying to the universities is that you need to look out for the universities that offer the course you want to need. And in our case, that's medicine. Some universities have it as human biology. It's the same thing. So the first thing, you need to look out for those universities. Two, you need to find the universities you want to attend, because there are so many, the government universities and the private universities. So I'm going to speak about the government universities alone, because I think the private university may have a different system. I'm not really quite familiar with. So I'm going to talk about the government schools. In my case, I applied to just two universities. I applied to KNUST and UDS only. I would suggest that you apply to as many universities as you can, because as I said earlier, getting into medical school is a competition, and applying to as many universities as you can gives you a better chance of at least getting one of them, or maybe two. Then you make your choice then. But in applying, you need to buy the forms. So I think in my time, that was in 2016, the forms cost around 200 to 300 Ghana cedis. That was the range, around 200 to 300 Ghana cedis. So I bought the forms for both KNUST and UDS. You just fill them out. They are pretty straightforward, honestly. They are pretty straightforward. And luckily for us in Ghana, we have like so many cafes that help you in filling out the forms once you go there, because you need to do one online and you need to do one manually. So you have the soft copy and the hard copy. So they help you with that in the cafes. You just print that out. You print whatever it is you have out. And one you buy from the bank, then you buy from any bank, most banks actually. And then you send it by post, you send one by email as well. Whatever requirements you would need are stipulated in the admissions form, whatever they need from you. Your WASI results, passport pictures, how many passport pictures they need, everything would be in that form. So you just need to follow the instructions of the admissions form and just do that. Luckily for us in Ghana, you do not need your transcript. You do not need to get your transcripts from your high school. You don't need that. You just need your WASI results. So that brings us to the WASI result. People ask, how do you apply to university whilst you are still in senior high school? I got one of these. Someone asked me this question on Instagram. On that note, please don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Twitter as well. So how do you apply to university when you are still in senior high school? What you do is this. Before the WASI examination begins, when the universities start selling these forms, what you need to do whilst you are filling these forms, you fill it as awaiting results. There's a section for that. When they ask you for the grades you get in each subject, biology, chemistry, physics, all you need to do is awaiting. For those of us, or for those of you who take the NOVDEC results, you get, there's another section for other examinations where you just write NOVDEC, you write the year, and then you write the grades you get for each. I think you would need to add a copy of your NOVDEC certificate. You need to add a copy of your NOVDEC certificate to that when you are sending it to them by post or by email. Another thing you would need to know is that there's a section for you to take whether you want to be a regular student or a fee-paying student. So what that means is that as a regular student, I think it means that governments, since these are government universities, so it means the government pays a part of your fees. I think that's what it means. Fee paying means that you are on your own, you have to pay everything yourself. And people are of the view that people who select the fee paying option actually have a better chance of getting in, even if their grades are not as high as someone who wants it regular. Because most people are going for the regular option. So if someone goes for a regular option and gets 6 A's, and I go for the fee paying option and I get 4 A's, I might get in and the person wouldn't, because I'm going to be paying everything in full, but that person isn't. I'm giving the university more money, I think. Let's talk about getting into medical school from a West African country. So this might shock a lot of people, but getting into medical school from a West African country is very similar as getting into medical school in Ghana. This is because we all take the same examination, which is the WASI, and I looked that up. Again, which stands for the West African Senior School Certificate Examination. So it's the whole of West Africa, so all West African countries take the same exam. We take the same paper, the same thing, the grading system, everything is the same. Except for a little things that varies per country. So it's the same thing, you just need that certificate. That's the only thing you need. You do not even need your transcripts or anything. But I think the thing that differs is the fact that you would have to state that you are a foreigner, you are a foreign student. And I think the fees vary and some other little things vary pertaining to how much you pay and everything. But the process, everything, the requirements are quite similar. And in applying to medical schools in Ghana when you are outside West Africa, it's also not that difficult because you need your transcript from your high school. If you have any exam, you need your certificates as well, certificates from the beginning and everything. So what you need to do is that you need to take that to the embassy. So the embassy needs to endorse those certificates and then you send them to the university as well. If you are from a non-English speaking country, what you need to do is, after taking it to the embassy for endorsement, you need to take it to any institution that offers English for it to be translated. The certificate needs to be translated into English, and you also need a certificate for English, so you need to study English as well. And that's it. It's as easy as that. Honestly, the whole application thing in Ghana is very easy. I hope this helps a lot. I hope I've answered a lot of your questions. I hope much of your concerns have also been touched. So I think this brings us to the end of this video. I told you it was going to be a short one. I hope it was. So thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was quite educative and informative. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. And please subscribe if you haven't done that already. Please comment. If you have any questions or any concerns, please leave them in the comments box. I'll address them as and when I can. Thank you so much. And if you are also curious about how life in medical school is, please do watch my videos. I'll link some of them up here so you check that out as well. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. See you in my next video. Over, just tell me what to...